I used to work in a media house at one point. So yes, they can. And they find their defense in fair comment, because it's basically just, you know, their perception of what they see. And at the same time, when someone appears in a public event, in a public space, they sort of forfeit their privacy rights. So because of that, then they are at will to do as they deem fit. So if you decide to dress carelessly, I'm sorry. Just get ready to be on the pulse and all these interesting presses. Then question on challenges. When I started out, to be honest, there was no money, and people were very skeptical in the entertainment industry about lawyers, because all of them would be like, see, you guys, your work is just to steal from us. Already I'm making kidogo money, so why do I need you? So I had to get creative. I had to be very approachable. At some point, I even to just be incognito at events to just, you know, relate to people, talk to people, and find out, okay, you know, what are your challenges? You know, what are you up to? Then I had to, you know, I just had to do my research to figure out how then I would make my space. And then in that, blogging had become a thing. I started a blog, and I became the go-to for information. And I had to be also creative, because my first blog post, I was such a lawyer. Yani, it was almost like I was writing a dissertation. And then someone said, you know what, Liz, please be approachable. Let us understand you. We don't know what you're talking about. So then I started, you know, I had to change my writing style and whatnot. Then, of course, I had to think outside the box to figure that out. And also how to make money as well. I had to think, again, outside the box. So if a designer comes and says, I'm launching a new line, I don't have money, I'd have to figure things out, and I'd be like, okay, what is your target audience? How are you planning to launch a line? Blah, blah, blah. And I tell them, okay, then give me a cut in every outfit you sell. That's how I would make money, yeah? And at the same time, I became relevant. So you have to think about your business models as well. And then when it comes to getting information as the law is evolving, of course, it's evolving faster outside Kenya, yeah? So for me, I started reaching out to international mentors and writers and other lawyers. So I would send a LinkedIn message to someone I have seen, you know, their work, and I would say hi. Of course, I watch my grammar and I sound professional and appealing, and I want them to respond to my email. So this Sasa Sema generation, we need to kill our, you know, how we talk and how we write especially makes a big deal. So I would, you know, reach out to people through LinkedIn. I write and express interest to international trainings, and I say hi, I'm a Kenyan lawyer, I am interested. And I'll be honest, I'm like, I don't have money, but this is what I would do, you know, given the opportunity, if you could give me a scholarship. I just had to be bold. And then based on that, I was able to attend some of the trainings internationally and make friends, you know, senior lawyers from other jurisdictions, New York, California. I made friends, and now they're my go-to people. Now when I encounter something interesting and I don't know what to do with it, I send an email and I say, hi, I have this kind of brief, help, where do I need to, you know, then they'll send me links or information, and that's how I have found my way through it. Yeah, but it's taken a lot of patience.